Hello friends, and in this video I'll be helping with how to subtract mixed numbers and whole numbers. So let's start. So I'm telling you the common technique which could apply with either if you are doing mixed numbers subtracted from whole number or vice versa. Okay, there are other techniques which you could follow, but they are a bit complex. So I'm just telling you a common technique. If you have a mixed number and a whole number and you need to perform subtraction, you can do this. Okay, so we have an example over here. Okay, we need to perform subtraction. So what is the first method I will say use? Convert them into fractions. Okay, so it will be 16 upon 1, and this also convert into fraction. So you can convert it 22 plus 4, 26 upon 11. All right, once you have them in a fraction form, what you can do is you can take the LCM. Now for LCM there is a technique, that is you can just write the bigger number, take the bigger number. Bigger number is 11, right? Between these two denominators. So take the bigger number and write 2-3 multiples of it. All right, and see whether other number can divide it or not. So whether 11 can be divided by 1 or not. Yes, it can be divided. So your LCM will be 11. All right, 16 11s are 16 tens are 160, 16 11s are 176 minus 26. All right, further on we can solve it. We'll get it as 150 upon 11. And now again you can write it in a mixed fraction form. If asked, 11 was 11 minus 4 0, 3 is 33 minus 7. Okay, so it will be 11 7 13. All right, that will be your final answer. And even if it is vice versa, that is your mixed fraction and you need to subtract whole number from a mixed fraction, that is vice versa of this, then also you can go with the same technique. That is the plus point of this technique. Okay, this technique applies on both the kind of subtraction, whether it is whole number from mixed number or whether it is mixed number from whole number. All right, what we did, let's again revise it. First thing you need to do is convert your whole number and your mixed number into your fraction form. All right, once you have them in the fraction form, take the LCM. For LCM I told you the technique. Okay, this technique, follow that technique. If you did not, go and watch that part again, you'll understand. Okay, once you have the LCM, do the subtraction or addition, whatever they have said you, get the final fraction and convert that back into your mixed number. And you'll be very quick with this, as you'll practice more and more sums. Okay, it's not at all time taking and all. So if you like the video, please do the like button, do consider subscribing, and thanks for watching.